Hello, this is Angular Waki based in the United States. Thank you for watching my video and supporting my channel. From the West Coast, I upload fishing videos every week introducing how to fish in the Japanese way using popular techniques in Japan and Japanese fishing gear. Holiday shopping. What did you buy? I bought some fishing tackles from Tackle Warehouse. Maybe some of you have already watched my video talking about it. Tackle Warehouse is a great online tackle shop handling many Japanese fishing lures. I often use them. I'd say they are my primary tackle store. How about other shops? Yeah. There is another great shop with plenty of JDM tackles. The Hook Up Tackle. They have many Japanese brands I love. Not just big brands like Jackal, O.S.P, Depths, Duraris, Evergreen, Norris, Rains, Megabass, etc. They also have other Japanese local brands which are hardly found in the United States, like Issei, Bottom Up, KASUMI DESIGN, Mibro, Ism, and more. Impressive! Like other shops, they had a holiday sale in December. I got some cool gear from them. This video is about unboxing my package from the Hook Up Tackle. Okay, let's open up the box. Oh, the first one, Ism Aeteris. Ism is a Japanese local lure fishing brand, ISM, Infinite Cheese Makers, Ism. Founded in 2016 in Osaka, Japan, the second big city in Japan. I have never had a chance to use their lure. This package is my first ISM lure, so I can't make any smart comments. But this looks nice, right? Checking out ISM's website, they recommend this for the mid-throwing and hover-throwing techniques. In 2023, I think I should make a video for those techniques. Anyway, my first choice for this lure would be a drop shot rig. With a light spinning setup, I guess this would work for not just largemouth bass, but also saltwater fish eaters, like California halibut. Next. Oh yeah, OSP. This blue package means this is a product for saltwater. Yes. I can see the word chinu. Chinu is a black sea bream, crodai. Recently, catching them using a lure has been getting popular in Japan. It's called chining. This lure is how it. I mean, a saltwater fishing version of the regular drive hog. Skirts and tentacles. Just like a K-Tech Little Spider and Yamamoto Flag Grab. But this one has paddle arms. Can be an awesome bait for Texas rig lifting and hauling. I know this type of lure greatly works for spotted bass anyway. That's why I got this. Sunny Bros. A small Japanese fishing brand. A relatively newer brand, I think. I was surprised the hookup tackle had their items. But sounds like not well sold. These products were on clearance sale. Drugstick. Looks like rain's bubbling shaker. Tons of ribs. Should be good for dropshot rig, neck rig, and weightless rig. But I know this type of weight can be fitting with any rig. I got two sizes. I hope this works great. This one is also from Sunny Bros. Knuckle Hog. My first impression was, oh, looks like O.S.P. Drive Beaver. Two huge paddle arms should be producing great action when I use this with Jika Rig or Free Rig. I'll use this for saltwater jetty fishing. Not sure how durable this is. If this is not that fragile, then this lure could be special. KASUMI DESIGN Hyper Omata Soft Swinches 4.6 grams. 4.6 grams means can be easily handled by bait finesse system. Looks like a lure for the current trend. Heavy backstride worms like Fat Eager and Kabaskat. Looks interesting. I want to try this in summer. KASUMI DESIGN is a company based in Chiba. I believe KASUMI means Kasumigaura, which is the second big lake in Japan. Tons of largemouth bass there. For bass fishing anglers in the Tokyo area, Kasumigaura and the rivers around are the places to go. Although, I know it's a heavily pressured lake. Oh yeah! IMAKATSU, Katsutaka Imae's fishing brand. Imae-san is a legendary bass pro in the Japanese bass fishing history. The brand, IMAKATSU, was founded in 2004. Since then, it has been producing many lures. This lure, Dadcat, looks like a regular hog lure. But checking out the website, it says, the most versatile lure. We can rig this on the Texas rig as is. We also can cut off the clouds and rig it like a tube worm. We can even reverse rig this. Then, it would look like Ika, Fariga. Wow, this is customizable. It's up to us how to use this. Interesting idea, right? This is a treble hook. RYUGI Pierce Treble. I can't remember why I bought this. I still have enough stock of treble hook number 6. Maybe because this was on extra sale? Okay, OSP again. This is Drive Crawler, Drakuro. I've been interested in this lure for long years, since many people say this is great. But I have already had a similar type of bait in my roster. Yamamoto Senko, Cattail, and Jackal Freak Shake. So that I've taken a distance from this lure. But this time, I finally decided to try this out. This is 3.5 inches. This is smaller than I thought. Maybe I should have bought a bigger size. Anyway, first, let's try. Then, if this really is great, I'll buy more. Oh my, beans sinker. Yeah, I had bought them from tackle warehouse, and now more from the hook up tackle. When I use a rig with a steady reeling, I'm fine with a regular Texas rig using bread weights. But with slow bottom dragging in the rocky area, I do prefer using this sinker, B-Free Texas rig. I bought 6 in 4 sizes. Maybe I was drunk when I made an order. Be careful. Online shopping with beer can be dangerous. That's all. The Hook Up Tackle is a great store. You can find many items that you cannot find in the local stores. See you. Bye bye.